Hello, my name is Inger van Duuren. I will briefly talk you through our narrative review titled The Developing Immune System in Preterm Born Infants from Contributor to Palliative Solution of Respiratory Tract Infections and Wheezing. Moderate and late preterm birth is related to increased risk of respiratory tract infections, wheezing, and reduced lung function. As a result, moderate and late preterm infants use medication more frequently and are hospitalized for respiratory diseases more often. Since about 8% of all births worldwide occur moderate or late preterm, and these infants are underrepresented in research, we think that this group harbors a large potential health gain and should be studied. It is not clear which mechanisms underlie the increased respiratory risks. Analysis of risk factors raises the hypothesis that deviation of microbiome and immune development plays an important role. Some important risk factors are antibiotic exposure and birth via cesarean section, which are both common in preterms. Some important preventive factors are breastfeeding and living on a farm. Importantly, all of these factors impact the microbiome and immune development. In our review, we describe these influences in detail and elaborate on how we think that it underlies the respiratory risks. Further, we discuss the microbiome and immune development after preterm birth and elaborate on potential therapies that may prevent respiratory diseases. This figure summarizes the development of the gut microbiome and different parts of the immune system throughout time, from pregnancy to infancy. Lower maturity of these systems at birth and earlier exposure to extrauterine life causes differences between term and preterm born infants. The gut microbiome differs in diversity and in composition. Preterm infants carry striking amounts of opportunistic pathogens, and term infants especially carry high levels of bifidobacteria. The different components of immunity are displayed as relative to each other. Innate and adaptive immunity develop, and immune regulation decreases throughout time. Innate and regulatory immunity develop equally for both groups, but because preterm birth happens earlier in time, those infants have relatively less mature innate immunity and more immune regulation, resulting in a higher infection risk. At last, transplacental IgG transfer is highest in the third trimester of pregnancy, which is suddenly interrupted by preterm birth, which leads to less maternal IgG in preterm infants. We explored a large amount of strategies to improve microbiome and immune development, aiming at reducing respiratory infections and wheezing. Interventions with accumulating evidence supporting a preventive effect include bacterial products, BCG vaccines, and anti-RSV prophylaxis, although more research is necessary to establish their true effectiveness. Also, the timing, duration, and route of administration are still subject of discussion and further research. Our review concludes that we need a better understanding of the microbiome and immune developmental trajectories during infancy in relation to respiratory tract infections and wheezing. This knowledge could steer us to more effective strategies to prevent these diseases in at-risk infants, such as those born preterm. Thank you for your attention.